It is odd to see a document like this posted inside a church, an Illinois state agency declaring credible evidence of child abuse has not been found. The priest at the church, Father Chester Prisbillo, wants everyone in the church to know molestation allegations against him are false.
I don't have any doubts about Father.
And yet there is this question. Why did the Archdiocese of Chicago agree to a huge settlement with a former altar boy who accused Father Chester of molesting him for years?
You're angry with the officials for
yes.
the settlement.
Yes, yes, because they never really had to do that in the first place.
Father Chester claims the Archdiocese paid the settlement not because he did anything wrong, but to get the case out of its hair. Notably, the Archdiocese of Chicago is not in control of Father Chester's church. The church is independent, so neither the Archdiocese nor the Vatican can stop him from preaching. The Archdiocese kicked him out of the church where the alleged molestations happened before these allegations became public.
But the implication is they said, you did this.
They said it's believable. They didn't say I did it.
But the church did pay the settlement, despite the state agency issuing that finding. However, the agency did not know a lot of the story. The church did not provide it with this stack of papers we now have.
For more than a quarter century, the Archdiocese of Chicago had documentation about Father Chester, but it was all kept secret until it was subpoenaed.
The records obtained by the former altar boy's attorney show the Archdiocese had serious concerns about Father Chester for many years. Allegations from other priests who suspected he was a child molester. A priest who said he saw Peter Galica in only his underwear sitting on Father Chester's floor.
It says in the documents that Peter was spotted in his underwear inside your bedroom.
Yeah, I mean, no, absolutely not. And the only thing, if there was anything that, you know, he could have had short pants on, so could have a person who just passed by could have thought that.
I guess here's an important point.
Is what I'm saying.
Why would he be in your bedroom?
No, he wasn't in my bedroom.
So you're saying the bedroom part's not true either?
You couldn't see my bedroom from the door.
But a bit later in our conversation, Father Chester did say sometimes there were boys in his private quarters.
Yeah, I had them in my bedroom. We watched TV because that's where my TV was. We sat on the bed. But we were dressed. That's all.
Would you do that today, have an altar boy in your bedroom?
No, because I don't have my TV there.
Another document indicated a different priest declared that Father Chester is paranoid, is crazy, and that he tried to proposition a priest.
Well, what is the real story?
Now, I really don't want to say it.
It's probably important that you do. That's not serious stuff.
Well, how about when a priest comes to you in your room in his underwear, and I told him I'll take you back to bed because he was drunk.
So you're saying this priest propositioned you?
No, I don't know. I just said, I'll take you back to your room. I'll take you back to your bed. That didn't mean I'm going to go to bed with you.
And then there is this document from the church archives. A group of parents writing to then-Cardinal Joseph Bernardine, alleging that 6 altar boys and 1 little girl were struck, punched, and kicked by Father Chester.
Did you hit those children?
Well, I went in there to just, hit them a little bit. Yeah.
Like all 7 of them? Though.
Well, because Bishop Abramovich wanted me to discipline the place.
Right, but what does a little bit mean? Like when you hit them a little bit, what does
it's just
mean?
A whack or something, you know.
Bishop Abramovich has since passed away. But Peter Galica said that bishop is the only person he ever had the guts to tell about the molestations in the years they went on.
She just started yelling at me. She said, listen, it's go to confession. Confess your sins. That was the end of it.
So why did the Archdiocese of Chicago settle this case? Does the man in charge, Francis Cardinal George, feel Father Chester is a dangerous predator? Or does the cardinal just want the case to go away? Or is it something else entirely?
There has never been an explanation to go with the large cash settlement. So keeping them honest, we repeatedly pressed the cardinal for an answer. Finally, a spokeswoman for the Archdiocese gave us a statement acknowledging something publicly for the first time. The Archdiocese Independent Review Board received an allegation of sexual misconduct with a minor regarding Father Prisbillo. In March of 2007, the review board found reasonable cause to believe that abuse occurred, and the allegation was substantiated. So the church now tells us it does indeed believe child molestation occurred. But the priest's attorney, Walter Maxim, tells us the Archdiocese has thrown the priest under the bus. They did no investigation. There's never been a hearing. They never even discussed this with Father Prisbillo. Both Peter Galica and Paul Gill say they've tried to kill themselves over the years. They are bitter and angry.
If he walked into a room you were in now, what would happen?
I would rather not have that happen.
Because?
Because I would hurt him. I would hurt him gravely.
Paul Gill hasn't filed a lawsuit as of yet, but the Archdiocese is paying for counseling for him.
How does it make you feel that he's still an active priest?
I just can't believe it.
Father Chester says this is all a conspiracy between men who are trying to make money from the church and church leaders who feel threatened by him, including one whom he said was senile.
I should be the leader. I should be guiding priest.
I'm saying all these things to you, and they're either senile, they're out for revenge, or they're angry. Why is everyone out to get Father Chester?
Because I have to pray and find the answer, and I have my answers.
And what is the answer?
My answer is Christ called me to be a priest, and I will stay a priest. And it will not be any...